and thirsty. So like this, whom do they belong to? Earlier I was not angry, hungry. Now I am hungry. Earlier I was not like that. How do you explain all these things? Atma is changing, vikari. So that is now explanation is given. And we are given. Says, Atmana Satchidamshascha Buddhehe Vrittihi Iti Dvayam Avivekena Sanyojya. By aviveka, lack of discrimination, not knowing the exact nature of what is Atma and what is Buddhi. Not knowing that, what has happened is some unwanted mix-up has taken. Sanyoga here is not simple union. Attributing the features of one to the other. What is the nature of Atma? Sat-chit Atma. What is the nature of Buddhi, Mana, Antakarana? Inert in nature. Yes or no? But what is their experience? Is mind inert in nature? A thought comes in the mind. Are you aware of it or not?
Yes.
Is it inert? If it were inert, will you say, will you? What is that? Experience says that. What do you say? I say, look, what has happened is, inert mind, inert buddhi, borrows the chetanata, sentience, from whom? Atma. And Atma, who is simply Sat Chit Ananda, totally free from antakarana, mind, buddhi, gets attributed by what? Mind, as if it is a feature of what? And therefore, whatever, avivekena sanyojya, janami, I know, this function takes. Now look, analyze this function, I know. When you say, I know, that I, what does it refer to? Atma? Or vritti, antyakarana vritti. Vritti means thought. Antyakarana vritti means thought. That I, does it refer to Atma or does it refer to Buddhi? If it refers to Buddhi, it should be inert or not.
Yes.
But what you refer to I is inert? When you say I, me, is it inert? No, no, then it will belong to Atma. Atma has no antakarana at all. Because it has no antakarana, there is no thought at all. That is what sanyojya avivekena. Atmanaha satchit avasya. Satchit avasya, or especially chit avasya of Atma, portion of Atma as chit, or avasya part of Atma as chit. You know what it means? A reflection of Chaitanya in the antakarana. Reflection of Chaitanya in the vritti antakarana, vritti thought, what it is called? Chidabhas. Just as sun is reflected in the water, that reflection is what? Suryabhas. Moon is reflected in the water. That reflection is what? Moon Chandra Abhasa. Chandra Abhasa. So Moon Abhasa. Why you call Abhasa? It is not true, but it appears to me. So, like that, the Chaitanya in the Antakarana is not, that is what we cognize. What we experience in Chidabhasa is not true Chaitanya, it is a reflection of that. It appears just as Chaitanya is Sachetana, sentient principle, So this reflection also appears to be Chaitanya reflection. This is what Sachetana preserves. So that is Atmanaha Sachidamshascha. This is one aspect. Buddhe vritti iti dvayam. The vritti, antakarana vritti, thought belong to buddhi. Is it called buddhi, mind, one and the same? But not one and the same thing. But in this context, it refers to what? Antakarana. Therefore, you see, these words we should be particularly careful. Mana antakarana consists of four functions. They are what? Mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta. And these functions are exclusively so. But in the text at time, one word is used for entire antakarana or one word is used for other also. You have to see the context and decide. That's what it is. Buddhi, avivekena sanyojya. Aviveka, what is aviveka? Atma has no vritti, vritti has no sentience. So, but janami iti pravarte, that is a vyavahara, that I know. When you say I know is a vritti. It should be inert. If it is inert, you are not able to aware of it, but you are aware of it because of what? Chaitanya. But Chaitanya doesn't have vritti. Borrowed from where? Antakarana. Is to get comfort. That is what Ramana Maharshi generally used to say. Upadesa. Ahamayam kuto bhavati chinvata ai patatyam nija vicharanam. Nija vicharanam. If you want to inquire into your true nature, what do you do? Where will you inquire? You want to find out what truly I am. So you have to refer to what you, by what you refer yourself to be I. What is that I? Ankara. Ankara. I notion. Entire body is me, this type of thought. Inquire into that. Aham, ayam, utaha bhavati. This I notion has come from where? Iti, chinvataha. In the case of a person who inquires like that, says, ayi, oh, whatever. Aham patati. There is nothing called I at all. Why? You take I vritti inert in nature. It cannot have sentience. You take Atma, it cannot have vritti. So who is this ahankara? To which party does it belong? Ahankara. Does it belong to Atma? You say it belongs to Atma. Atma has no upadhi. It has no upadhi means it has no antakarana. It has no vritti, it comes. Does this sentience belong to antakarana? No, it is inert in nature. It is inert in nature. If you have got doubt, Chandogya Upanishad has got an experiment for you. Would you like to do that? Say, what does Uddalaka does is, our total mental energy, it divides into 16 parts, 16 kalas, to demonstrate mind by itself is inert in nature. It is the product of food assimilated by you. And then we said, Svetaketu, please do one thing, 15 days fast. Not your upavasa. That is upahasa. You know what is upahasa? Farce. It is upahasa. You say fast and there is a long list in Maharashtra, in the hotels, etc. Board is there. Upavasa takes time. उपवासाचे सामान तयार आहे. मी असं वाट म्हणजे उपवास पोटॅटो चिप्स पोटॅटो चिप्स अँड म्हणजे साबुदाणा वडा. व्हॉट्स इट हॅपन्ड? वी वर ॲट महाबळेश्वर. महाबळेश्वर अँड इट हॅपन्ड टू बी चतुर्थी, नॉट दिस भाद्रपद चतुर्थी, गणेश चतुर्थी, चतुर्थी. सम पीपल हॅव गॉट फास्ट नो. Somebody said, we don't want much, some potato chips. Don't want much, some potato chips. I said, okay. So, that is a long list of items by upavasa. So, that is that. So, no, not that. No food. No food. See, if even a good thing can be a mockery afterward. By such practice, you know really what it means, upavasa. Upavasa. What is meant by upa? Near. Vasa means what? Dwelling. Dwelling near God. That is upavasa. Varaha Upanishad says, natu kayasya shoshanam. Not imagining the body. Either imaging the body or as children we must have enjoyed upavasa, because mother does upavasa and we get additional items. Our regular food is there, but some additional items we get. So that is different thing. So that is it. Says 15 days no food. But beta, do one thing. Drink lots of water. You don't drink water, goodbye. Who pranas will say goodbye? And I will have to go behind the bar afterwards. So drink lot of water. Okay. 16 days, father called the son Svetaketu, Uddalaka, father called. Beta, come on, recite Vedas, pass mastery with all the four Vedas. With flying colors he has come back from Gurukula. He was so arrogant also. So father said, come on, recite Vedas. I can't recall it. I can't recall it. Well, now, take slowly what? Put after some time. Come on, recite Vedas. Full swing. Beta, what happened? You had not taken the food for 15 days. That assimilated food which goes into the makeup, making up of what? Mind was not available. Your mind dwindled. Only one part was there. That what got nourished up. Just like, see, a log of wood. Totally burned, only small pieces of charcoal, cinders, burning charcoal is there, like that of a glower. Fire is present, but flames are not. What can you do? Take dry grass and slowly fan it and slowly go on adding the wood. Can be again ablaze. So like that, this mind wherein only Shodashakala, 16th part is there, by food you can what? Nourish it to a full mind as well. So that what does it mean? Mind is the product of food. Food is inert or sentient? Thank God. If food were sensitive, what would happen? You know what is that? All of us will die long back. You know why? Moment you go to eat the food will run away. Bhakshaka has come. Rakshasa has come. Demon has come to swallow me. The food will run away. Somebody said, you know, non-vegetarian food is not meant for us. You know why? If it comes to know that you are eating, it will run away. What about vegetable? Major is not only because Bhagavan has created meant for what? Our consumption only. Our consumption only. So, food is in earth, mind is in earth, but does our experience tell it so?
No.
What has happened? The essentials have been borrowed from where? Chaitanya Atma. But Chaitanya Atma is totally free from what? Thought. So this is unholy blending. Why unholy blending? All samsara starts because of this. Entire sorrowful samsara because of this only. So that is iti nija vicharana. In this context we have seen a story. You are aware of that. Which Ramana Maharshi used to quote very often. See, olden days, marriage is where being celebrated for 3-4 days. I think now I have come to know, nowadays also 3-4 days. You know, this is the effect of what? Mass media. Mainly. Then music. Oh, no brain at all. How they should celebrate? Who decides? Mass media. There are some people who make money out of that. And this, nowadays I am told, even there is uniform dress. Later somebody told, uniform dress. Means all couple and all those things, they are similar type of this thing. Somebody's brain behave just to make money and his idiots fall for it. No original brain at all. This is a pitiable thing. It's a pitiable thing. You know that? So they hear that. Gatanugati, you should be aware of this. Don't fall prey to this mass media. Have original what? Thinking essence. Gatanugati ko lokaha, na lokaha, paramarthikaha. Setav saikatalinkena nashtamme tamrabhajanam. People, gatanugatika, they simply follow the masses. Sheep philosophy. What is sheep philosophy? The first one, whatever course directed, others follow. If you want to do tamasha, you want that. Suppose the herd of sheep is going in the front, hold a stick. Not too high so that they can duck and go. Not too low that they can walk on. In between, they have to jump. One jumps. Other jumps, four jumps, remove the stick, then jump and go, like that. One person went to Setu. What is Setu? Rameshwaram, to take bath. He went early in the morning, said before the crowd comes, let me have a good bath in the ocean. But he had a chambu. Multi-purpose pot. If he keeps on the shore and goes, somebody will pinch it away. So what is the thought? Let me bury under the sand. Then he thought, if I bury under sand, how will I be able to locate the place afterward? Then he took my breath. Let me make a Shivalinga. So let me make a Shivalinga. And I made a Shivalinga. And then what happened? He went. Had a half an hour, one good bath, etc. And returned. He said, hundreds of Shivalinga. All around, hundreds of Shivalinga. What happened? When he was doing, some other vessel coming. They had seen him doing something. And then pilgrims newly coming, etc. Oh, this must be the custom here. What is this? Before the bath, you have to make a sand linga and go. They made it. When he comes, if he demolishes, Babri Masjid demolishes. It will be Babri Masjid demolishes afterwards. So, because Gatanugati Kodoka, people follow the masses, sheepish in their mentality, na loka paramarthika. People don't have original thinking. Why? సేతం ఈ రామేశ్వర సైకత లింగేన సైకత విశ్వాన్ లింగ ఏ శివలింగ నష్టం మే తామ్ర భాజన మై కాపర్ వెసల్ గాట్ లాస్ట్ సో లైక్ దట్ దిస్ ఇస్ హౌ ఇట్ ఇస్ సో నౌ సో కమింగ్ టు దిస్ దట్ ఓల్డెన్ డేస్ మ్యారేజ్ ఓకే బి కేర్ఫుల్ జస్ట్ డోంట్ వేస్ట్ మనీ Instead of just wasting money for one's vanity's sake, feed the poor. How many people are starving every day? Feed the poor as don't anything. But it needs that little courage against the customs, etc. Or what that party will think, what this party will think, etc. You should have the courage, yes. Nothing doing. To have that courage, that is. This reminds me one more thing. I was at Nagpur. So one elderly gentleman told me this thing. See, daughter of, in the days, a collector, district Indian, was to get married. Then, as a daughter of a rich person was to get married. And the boy was the son of a district collector. And this father of the girl was very patriotic. So the alliance was struck. And at that time, the father, girl's father said, please, no foreign things in the wedding. All Swadeshi. The boy's father, the collector was a sensible person, yes, certainly. His wife said, we want, let us have English bank. He said, we have agreed to the condition, etc. Why you should? No, let them not pay, we'll pay for that. Let the girl's party need not pay, we'll pay for that, let us have it. And she insisted. And what? English band was what? Played by whom? Not English people. Indian school. And the marriage started. The DSP. DSP means what? District Superintendent Pole. He is the Englishman. And of course, he was invited. He was invited. And he, because the collector's son, etc., he came with the wife. Moment the wife entered, so she got so angry, went to the bank people, stop it, nonsense, he said. No, English woman, so, and was wife of who? DSP, police authority. Bank people got nervous. You know what they were playing? Funeral beat. They don't know what is to be, what is what, play and what that. Then there was something to play. Funeral beat. She knew what it is. At a wedding, funeral beat. So like that, so we should be very careful. In fact, it once happened. I was staying at one place. Then nearby there was a hall. Some Jain festival was there. And they have got a habit of getting the band, etc. And you know what was the tune? Some filmy song, Kurbani, Kurbani. You must be knowing that song. Kurbani, Kurbani means what? Slaughter, slaughter. Something mangala, auspicious thing is going on. And I felt like I said, go to this. Anyway, so that for those days, the marriages were celebrated for 3-4 days. And the bridegroom's party used to go where? To the bride's house. And not like that, nowadays flights and all this, such a thing, chartered bus and all, they are not that. They have to go walking. While walking, in between, a youngster got trapped in. He joined the party. Nobody noticed me. He was also married. And when the bride's house came, they are all received in there and made to stay and all arrangements were done, etc. This was also all there. What this person was doing is, he went to bride's father and told, see, they are not happy with you. You should honor like this. You should give such and such gifts to them, etc. And all that. See, don't think, do you know who is that boy? Government officer. Those days, government officer is what? A big person. Government officer. You may be rich. What does it mean? Government officer. They are very unhappy with you. You can imagine them. They are thinking of breaking the marriage. You can imagine the plight of the poor girl's father. Don't worry. I will manage it. You give this with these things, etc. They give. He took it and went where? The boy's father. Your son may be officer, but do you know, with a girl, daughter of a such a rich person, you have to honor them. You understand? They are very unhappy. And don't worry, I will manage that. You give them. Like that, you are swindling from both parties. And somehow, the marriage was over, and both in-laws met over a cup of coffee. By the time this fellow was going by the girl's father, who is he? The boy said, who is he? Neither he nor. So, he overheard it. Packed all that was collected and what? Disappeared. Now tell me, this imposter belonged to which party? Girl's party or boy's party? Similarly, don't think I'm telling you a pocket. This is not my story. This is a famous story by Ramana Maharshi. Similarly, tell me, ahankara, I motion belongs to which party? Atma party or antakarna party? If you say Atma party, Atma has no antakarna, has no vritti. If you say antakarna party, antakarna has no sentience, chaitanya. Does it belong to? But place all mischief. What mischief? Not this swindling. Samsara. Sorrowful samsara in present. This ahankara. See, if you did, aham, ayam, kutaha bhavati, this ahankara, from where is it born? I know, sure, where is it born? If you inquire, are ahankara, is it? Ayi, look, patati, gone. Like somebody said, like our present day ministers, may not be this ministry, earlier ministers. They say there are some entities vicharam na sahate. They can't stand scrutiny. One of them is ahankara, other is maya. In the modern world, all is whatever it may be. So depending on the case, not that there are good people also as such, I don't say that. So that they say, that is, Atmanaha Satchit Aumshascha Buddhehe Vritti Iti Dvayam. These two aspects, because look here, Buddhe Vritti doesn't have Satchit aspect. Satchit aspect doesn't have the Vritti. Both have got combined. Means one thing is superimposed on the other. Sayoja, Sayoja here is what? Tadatmya Adhyasa, because Atma is Asanga. It has no connection with anything whatsoever, but as if it appears, Buddhi Vritti is its feature. Janami iti parvati. Janami iti. This I know, with this what? All vyavahara takes. All vyavahara takes. Same thing is further explained.
Atmano vikriya nasti.
Atmano vikriya nasti.
Buddhe. बुद्धेर्बोधो न चात्वपि जीवः सर्वमलं ज्ञात्वा ज्ञाता दृष्टेति मुह्यति। अन्वय आत्मनः जातु अपि विक्रिया न अस्ति बुद्धेः बोधः एड जातु अपि टू बी एडेड जातु अपि न जीवः सर्वं अलं ज्ञात्वा जीवः सर्वं ज्ञात्वा अलं ज्ञाता दृष्टा द्रष्टा इति मुह्यति।
What I have seen is now clearly specified. आत्मनः विक्रिया नास्ति। In Atma, changes are not there. Atma doesn't change. Can you understand this? Atma doesn't change. What your experience is? I was quiet. Now I have become what? Restless. I was full. Now I become hungry. Change or not? How would you say Atma? Inquire further. Yes. These are changes, correct? Now that Atma I were really to change, you know what would have happened? Like suppose in a particular ministry, minister goes on changing. What will happen? But while changing, at least what is there? Handing over the charge is there. What do you mean by handing over the charge? Means the earlier one is supposed to tell him what is all about. Is it not? That is there. But if it is frequently so, they won't know what is happening, etc. Like that here, see, if Atma, you may say, we don't know what is Atma, etc. At least I is there, whatever you refer as I. If it changes, earlier I is not now. That I is not afterward. That I is not later. Do you know what will happen? In our life, all that we know, who knows it? I, whatever it may be, that does not bother about jiva, atma, etc. I know that. And if it changes, what is known by the earlier one is not known by the subsequent one. Yes or no? Does it happen at any time? See, look, now you are awake. I hope so. You are awake. Now, afterward, class is over, you go home, take dinner, etc., you sleep. After sleeping, or you may dream also. But finally, tomorrow morning, you are going to wake up. Then what you are there? Are you sleeping? No. Are you dreaming there? No. You are again awake. Just try to recollect what all happened. I, who was awake, slept. And possibly in between I have dreamt. Again, I am awake. Don't you refer to the one and the same entity?
Yes.
And is it not that entity remembers all these things? Can it be different?
No.
This is called as pratyabhidnya. Recollection, pratyabhidnya. Pratyabhidnya is what? Recollection. Me who was awake, went to sleep, perhaps dreamt, again I am one and the same me is what? Avik. Vikriya or Sakriya? Akriya. No Vikriya, no change, Akriya. And that is why changeless. If, see, look here. What you experience in the waking, dream, deep state, are they one and the same? No, they differ. But the one entity who knows all is one and the same. Changing phenomena is known by a changeless entity. Yes, sir. Now, come on, tell me, is it not true? To know the changes, a changeless principle is required.
Yes.
Then we have seen the example. What is that?
Rails.
Railways. These railway rails, always thinking, only this train runs. And I have to be all the time stationary. Let me also what? Who? What has happened? For the trains to run stationary, rails are necessary. So to know the changing phenomena, a changeless entity is indispensable. Otherwise, you cannot know because entity goes on differing. Yes. That being the case. Atmanaha vikriya nasti. Atma has no vikara, no change. It is one and the same all the time. Buddhehe atmanaha vikriya. Atmanaha jatu api vikriya nasti. Jatu api means kadachit, at times. Na jatu means never. Jatu means at times. Na jatu, never. Atma has never what? Any change. Buddhe jatu api bodhahana. As for buddhi antakarna, na jatu, never there is what? Bodha means knowledge principle. We have just seen. Buddhi antakarna is product of what? Inert food. It has no sentience at all. But yet, what happens? Jivaha, jivaha, it is sarvam alam nyatva. See, here alam nyatva means identifying with, taking them to be oneself. What is the sarvam? Antakarana adhikam. Antakarana, mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, indra, jnanendriyas, karmendriyas, all these is what takes as what? I, jnata, identifying with them. See, jivaha, sarvam, sarvam means from antakarana onwards, all this is jnatva, jnatva miti, aham iti buddha. Having known them to be I, mistaking them to be I. What does it do? Jnata drashta iti muhyati. Muhyati, due to ignorance, gets deluded. I am jnata, knower, drashta, seer. In that, or, and patantara is there in the place of jnata. Karta is there. Karta means I am the doer. I am the doer, I am the knower, I am the seer, I am the hearer. All these because of identifying with the upadhi. Muhyati. Muhyati means what? Gets deluded and suffers the samsara. Why suffer samsara? Identifying with the organs of action, I mistake myself to be the doer karta. When I am the karta, what is the consequence? I am responsible to what? Experience the results of action. So I have to be necessarily bhokta experience. Samsara start. Muhyati. Jnata drashta iti. still and doubt is possible like this. Say, look, that is raga, dvesha, etc. belongs to whom you say, buddhi. I think not, we can't believe this. Look, you tell me, sukha, dukkha, etc., from where they come? How they come? How do you get it? Sukha, dukkha, how do you get it? They just come like that. They are flying, ice cup. Is it? Result of our karmas. Because of our karma phalas. Now tell me, you only told us, so buddhi is what inner? Does it do? When it doesn't do, is it responsible for the result of somebody else done? No. One well done must answer the bhoga. How is it? So, don't you think that our experience is, I do, I suffer, I enjoy, is what I have done. How can you ascribe to whom? Buddhi. So you are saying that it all belongs to whom? Buddhi is not correct. But number one, it is inert in nature. Number two, it is not a doer at all. For which? Says yes. But equally, it cannot belong to Atma. Why? You only told us. What did you tell us? That one is a doer has to answer the results of it. Can you prove Atma is a doer? Why not? Come on. To do, what is necessary? Upadhi, body. Does upadhi, body belong to Atma? How can Atma do? Can Atma eat? Can Atma drink? Be careful. So, you want to gain the knowledge of what? Atma. And that Atma can't eat and drink. What is your plight afterwards? Not that we accept. Atma is nirupadhika, free from embodiment. Embodiment is inner. Inner embodiment cannot act, and nirupadhika atma cannot act. In between, some entity crosses. You know who is he? That is what is called as jiva. It is a bhranti, a brahma, it is an erroneous notion. That guy is answerable for all things. So that is otherwise called ahankar. So that is now explained.
Rajju sarpavadatmanam.
Rajju sarpavadatmanam.
Jivam jnatva bhayam vahet.
Jivam jnatva bhayam vahet.
Naham jiva paratmeti.
Naham jiva paratmeti.
Jnatasche nirbhayo bhavet.
Jnatasche nirbhayo bhavet.
Anvaya as it is, Rajju sarpavat atmanam jivam jnatva
iti at the jnatva iti
jnatva. Jivam iti jnatva bhayam vahet na aham jivaha paratma iti jnataha chet.
You take aham jivaha na.
Aham jivaha na.
Add kintu.
Add kintu paratma iti jnataha chet nirbhayaha bhavet.
This is how samsara takes. Rajju sarpavat. As rope mistaken for a snake. Means What is that? If a rope is mistaken for a snake, that is what is called as what? Bhranti. Erroneous notion. Only that much you take. Don't go further. A rope mistaken for a snake means erroneous notion, Brahma, Bhranti. Like that. Atmanam jivam iti jnatva. Jnatva nishchitya. Having concluded, Atmanam, Satchidananda Atmanam, what? Jiva, samsari jiva. Just as rope is mistaken as a snake, Atma who is a samsari, who has no sukha dukkha atmaka existence, is mistaken as what? Samsari jnatva. Bhayam bahe. Here, bhaya, fear for all sukha dukkha atmaka samsara. Sukha dukkha and all these things are what? To be jiva, what is necessary? Come on, define jiva. Give me equation. Jiva is equal to. You see it? Jiva is equal to what? Gross body, subtle body, causal body, plus Chidabhasa. Ankara is already there. Subtle body, Ankara is there. Chidabhasa. This is what it is. So what you do? How come that Chidabhasa has come there? Antakara. Chaitanya, remove the antakarana. What will happen? Chidabhasa will go. Chidabhasa goes. Is that jiva? Is that? How to do that? See, you stand in front of mirror. How many are there? Two, three. You is your face, mirror plus reflection of your face. Three are there. Remove the mirror. How many are there? This is Vedantic mathematics. This is three minus one is equal to one. 3 minus 1 equal to 1. So that being the case, said, how will you remove the antakkar? How, why it has come there? Because of your ignorance. You don't know your swarupa. You are preoccupied in many things. Why are you preoccupied in many things? See, look, what is the fuel for this mind or antakarana to keep on going? Yena kena prakarena, by hook or crook, don't think. You do what you want. Don't think. In their mind? No. What is mind? Series of thoughts only. This is thought. Why these thoughts crop up? You are interested in the Vishaya sense object. Why you are interested in the sense object? But how much maja maja milega? Maja maja milega, milega. Oh, okay. Milta hai thappad ho de blood only. So that is it. That hope is there. Why that? Arre, you are Paramananda Swarupa. You are limitless Ananda Swarupa Atma. Is it? I don't know. You have come to sense system. I don't know Adhyana. Because of Adhyana, you mistake yourself to be sorrowful entity. Because our upadhi belongs, sorrow belongs to you. So you want to hunt for happiness in the Vishaya. Therefore, what? That is why Vedanta first insists on what? inquire into the objects to the right, in the right perspective. Develop vairagya. That is the case. That is, jivam jnatva, by mistake, identifying with this embodiment as a consequence of the chidabhasa available in the antakarana, taking the embodiment as I, so considering oneself as samsari jiva, bhayam vahe, means what? Bhaya vahe, gets, bhaya. Bhaya means yes, not simply fear, sukha dukkha atmaka samsara. So what is the remedy for that? Aham jivahana, I am not a jiva. What is our equation of jiva? Cross body, plus subtle body, plus causal body, plus chitta. So our equation of jiva. I am not jiva. How will we verify it? This gross body can be I? Why not? I am aware of it. Drishya, I am drashta, seer. Seer is different from the seer. Knower is different from the known. Experiencer is different from the experience. Therefore, this gross body cannot be I. Can this subtle body be me? Are you not aware of antakarana? Are you not aware of mind? Are you not aware of buddhi? Are you not aware of ahankara? Causal body, synonym for ignorance. Are you aware that you are ignorant or not?
Yes.
Otherwise, you would not have landed in Vedantakta. So that is that. That means what is it? I am distinct from Kidavasa. Are you aware of or not?
Yes.
Inquire. This is what is called as, come on, tell me, Atmanatma Vichara. What is Atma? I. What is Anatma? Not I. This implies, as guided by what? Vedanta Upanishad. So, aham jiva. Now, who are you? I am Paratma. Paratma. Where is Paratma? Sarva Sakshi. Just now you have seen. The one who is aware of all these. Cross body, subtle body, causal body, ajnana, and even the notion that I am such and such thing. That is the paratma. Iti jnatashche. Iti, if it is sakshatkara is there, if such direct knowledge is there, nirbhayaha bhavi. No more identification in the body, nirbhaya, free from bhaya for sukha dukkha atmaka samsara. Free from sukha dukkha atmaka samsara. Nirbhaya. So therefore, what is to be got rid of? What is to be got rid of? This wrong notion. How will you get rid of wrong notion? By getting rid of this. Ajnana. How will you get rid of ajnana? Directly know what is your true.
Swasti prajapya paripadayanta nyayena margena mahi mahisha go brahmanebhya shubhamastu nityam Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanyaha prithivi sasya shalini desho yamsho bharahitaha brahmana santu nirbhaya om sarve bhavantu sukhinaha sarve santu niramayaha Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Mahaschid Dukkha Bhagvavet asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityorma amrutam gamaya. Om purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. Om shanti 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 hari om shri gurubhyo namaha hari om.
Into it.